Good afternoon. My name is Jean-Paul Ferrer. I am your host today. And with me is a special person here in Chicago, Consul General Gina Hamora-Lin.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you, JP, and good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So today what we will talk about is a recap of the second ever Paskuhan, which is the celebration of Filipino-American nonprofit organizations celebrating Christmas together. But before we move on, I kind of want to talk about and brag about Consul General Hamora-Lin's credentials. So she originated actually coming from the Consul General of Hawaii. She held her post in Hawaii back in 2014. And her previous postings were in Bucharest, Romania from 1996 to 2002. Tokyo, Japan from 2006 to 2012. She passed her Philippine Forest Service examination in 1991. Consul General Hamora-Lin joined the Philippine Foreign Service in January 1992. She earned her PhD in economics from the University of Santo Tomas and a Master of Public Administration from the University of the Philippines. She also earned her MBA from McGill University in Tokyo and completed a postgraduate diploma in international relations from the Institute of Social at The Hague, ISS, the Netherlands, and the diplomatic course for junior Asian diplomats at the Institute of Diplomacy and Foreign Relations in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Consul General Hamora-Lin initiated the proposal for the Sakata Day Bill. And that bill unanimously passed in April 2016 that acknowledged 15 Filipino plantation farmers in Hawaii. The consul also initiated a bunch of programs, including encouraging future generations of Filipino to learn to speak Filipino, the Ilocano Language Acquisition and Immersion for the Next Generation, ELINE Project, graduated 20 students in 2014. So starting the Paskuhan here in Chicago is not something that's new to Consul General Hamora-Lin. She's done something similar. So Consul General, and we typically call her ConGen for short, we're going to be saying that. So you have a very list of a lot of experience and highly credentials. So why don't you describe a little bit about your experience working here in Chicago?
Okay. First, they say that, wow, from Hawaii, you're going to Chicago. It's a totally different environment. But believe me or not, I was so excited also to come to Chicago, having, you know, the reputation of Chicago as a dynamic city. And, of course, I was happy to be in Hawaii, but sometimes, you know, you follow where your work brings you.
Right.
So it was a decision of my government to assign me to Chicago. And, of course, it is a totally different geographic structure, I may say, because when I was in Hawaii, I covered the different islands of Hawaii.
Wow.
Several islands, and I also covered American Samoa. So I always flew by air.
Okay.
But here in the Midwest, you know, many of the states under me, which are 12, are accessible by land.
Mm-hmm.
If we can do it by land, we travel by land or by air. If it's like Nebraska or Kansas, we travel by air. But it's really the geographical distance. It's a challenge. But it's a challenge that I'm willing to take. And I really enjoyed my travels to the different states tremendously. If I may say, can I say all the states under me?
Yeah, go ahead.
Under the Midwest, we cover Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Michigan, Minnesota, Missouri, North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Ohio, and Wisconsin.
Yeah.
So that's the heartland of America.
And some of those states are colder than Chicago. So
yes.
Totally understand how that is. Now, Paskuhan, our topic for today, that's one of the big projects that you brought in two years ago. So you and I were talking and you mentioned the first one is always tough because we're trying to feel our way. The second one, on the other hand, the first one had 250 people show up. This time around, the second year, 360 people showed up. So what was your vision of the Paskuhan, and kind of like, where do you want to see it get transformed to?
Okay, when I initiated the Paskuhan last year, The purpose is to really bring together all the various organizations here. Actually, my greater ambition is to bring all the organizations in the all 12 states, but that's not really, that's a challenging one. So we start, I started, maybe we can do it in Chicago, where it's more physically, you know, accessible, and the organizations are really, they know each other. So something, the something that, you know, everyone shared. Right. So we all share the Christmas spirit. We all miss Pasko sa Pilipinas. Mm-hmm. So I think there's no question about it. So that's one goal that everybody can share, right?
Right.
So I said maybe Paskuhan, like what we did in Hawaii, would be a good theme.
Right.
A common theme for everyone. So that's how, yeah, you're right. At first, we had to call on the different organization. We had to make two call yeah. for participant twice.
Right.
And finally, of course, with the cooperation of my friends, I mean, you know, the organizations that really were really there the first time I arrived. So we were able to come up with a good program, but from 20 organizations in the first year, this time we had around 30.
Right.
So
right.
I remember the first Paskuhan, I had PACF as our co-chair.
Right, Philippine American Cultural Foundation. Yeah.
As a co-organizer, and this time we have the ISPA.
Right. International Societies of Filipinos in Finance and Accounting, as a matter of fact.
Yes.
Yeah.
But one nice thing about it is the organizations are increasing.
Yes.
So we retained the same core, but this the second year, this time, we had more organizations.
Yeah.
And that is what is nice thing, beautiful about that Paskuhan. You know, as I was saying in my speech, big or small organization, they are the same.
Right. Let me quote you on what exactly you said that you sent out to the community. And Consul General, you said this. Consul General Gina Hamura-Lin congratulated the planning committee, community, leaders, and guests for their commitment and dedication to the success of this year's second Paskuhan sa Chicago after a successful launch, first Paskuhan sa Chicago on December 15, 2018 at Seafood City. She hoped it will become a yearly event for the Filipino community in Illinois, a unique activity to bring together all Filipino-American organizations in Illinois. Consul General Hamura-Lin praised the commitment of the community leaders to spend their weekends planning the event, whether big or small, each organization has a place on the table, and that's what you quoted it as.
Yes.
So we're gonna. I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna ask you what your feedback is. But what I'm gonna do is show you a 1 minute video of the planning that went through.
Okay.
So we have a little bit of a recap here.
The committee members, which are the head of the organizations, we met for 4 months to make this happen. And I'm out here talking on their behalf. And this never would have happened without the meetings that they've attended. And this is not a presentation for you, but a presentation for amongst us. Get ready in 20 minutes because everybody put in the effort.
Oh, guys, we need you guys upstairs.
And this is not somebody's idea. This is Tom Jen's idea. First time in Illinois, in Chicago, where we got together the first 2 years of Paskuhan. It's our responsibility to keep it going. So let's keep it going.
Introduce yourself so we can... It's like it flew by, didn't it? Four months of preparation, all of a sudden, boom, here it is. We're celebrating it a week ago.
And I know I had unguarded moments, too.
Yeah?
My hairstyle was different.
That's awesome. So, I mean, you know, with this experience with Paskuhan, what are some of the highlights that you have? I mean, you know, first of all, I want to thank you for doing this. And I said this at the Paskuhan. A lot of the committee members and I would see each other in each other's events from their organizations. We get invited, we invite them, we share ideas, but it's always hello in passing.
Mm-hmm.
Paskuhan is the only event here in Chicago where 30 organizations sat down, met bi-monthly, and actually celebrated Christmas together, which is what Paskuhan is for those that are not catching on yet. Mm-hmm. So what are some of the highlights for you?
Well, the highlights are first, I enjoyed the process. That's obvious. This is, you know, it's like a work in labor of love, a work in progress. Right. Of course, nothing is perfect. But bringing together 20 to 30 organizations with different, you know, backgrounds, with different, experiences is a challenge. And bring them together and take out the best in them.
Right.
Their resources, their time. That is the best part. And in the end, you come up with
a beautiful event,
well organized, and the people are enjoying.
Yes.
So that is something I said, oh, wow, this is our second year. But I would say, oh, my God, look at this. You see all the decoration. You know, how can we do that? All 20 organizations, different personalities, 30 this year. So that's one. And second is the program.
Yes.
The program, which is, it's different. The first one, we had a different program. The second one, different. And the third, maybe the way we are observing the Simbang Gabi.
Yes.
And the parol. These are classic Filipino traditions.
Okay.
You know, I mean, which is really part of how Filipinos celebrate Christmas. And I wish we can bring in more Filipino tradition. I think, of course, we have the gift giving.
Right.
Yeah, and the children. So I think there's a lot that, you know, depending on the perspective, maybe that's from my own point of view, that's what I like.
Yeah.
And the cooperation of the people.
So, Khan Jan, you obviously are the representative of the Philippine government here in Chicago. If you're going to talk to our audience, and you can face the camera here, should we keep this going every year?
Of course.
See, this
absolutely.
Is straight from Khan Jan. We got to keep this going every year. And, you know, for me, one of the biggest moments there is the fact that you talked about the decorations.
Yes.
The decoration, the physical arrangement committee started doing the decoration at 12 p.m. I believe you got there at 1 p.m.
Yes.
And you would think that they actually took the night before to decorate the room. And I'm about to show a highlight. So a lot of people that in meetings were very quiet because they're plotting the way that they will decorate. You should have seen it. We didn't have access to the gym until 12 p.m.
Wow.
But by 10 a.m., people were there.
Wow.
The table cover, they already pre-cut.
Mm-hmm.
So that at 12 o'clock, as soon as the table were done, they put it on top, they put the centerpieces,
yes,
and the chairs were assembled.
And these are free.
Yes.
This is, they come on their own.
On their own, yeah. It's
so
not
that's
a,
one thing, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Coming in there, we did charge $25 per person to pay for the food.
But the people working behind.
Yeah. Yeah, oh yeah, the volunteer work.
The volunteer, that's really
awesome. That's the
awesome.
Biggest thing, and you realize that's what you brought to Chicago. Bringing not just one group, but 30 people coming together, right? And we all, as an organization, we have our goal, right, as an organization to promote certain things about the Filipinos and our community. But you brought all 30 of them to celebrate Christmas, and I'm about to show you the highlight. And when I saw this, it actually, it would bring tears to, if you are part of the organizing community, you would actually feel happiness when you see this. So let's go watch this.
This happened. 1, 2, 3. And this never would have happened without the meetings that they've attended. And this is not a presentation for you, but a presentation for amongst us. We got this gym ready in 20 minutes because everybody put in the effort.
So we'll cut there. So that's your idea. That was your idea.
No, it's no longer my vision. Idea.
Okay.
Second year.
That's a good transition.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's a second year. So now a lot of these organizations, you said PACF, Philippine American Cultural Foundation, took it first year. The second year, International Society of Filipinos in Finance and Accounting took it over. So hopefully the third year, we can maintain this by actually bringing in another organization and said, how else can we add and bring Filipino tradition here in the United States? So switching gears, I know it's the end of the year. I know you have a lot of ideas in your head. What are some of the initiatives that you'd like to kind of tell our Kababayans to kind of looking in 2020?
My staff won't like this, but
they're hearing it first.
I already forewarned them.
Okay.
First, let's continue the Paskuhan, maybe a bigger one. The only thing that prevents us, as I said, from inviting more people is the physical space.
Right.
If we can, both venues, the first and second, are great. But it's always, how come you always feel that we need
it's
more?
It's too small.
Yeah, that's one thing I know.
Great problem to have.
Yes, nothing is too large for us, right?
Yeah.
Because you see the enthusiasm. So
right.
Hopefully, if we have a bigger venue, we can invite more.
Yep.
More from the public. And secondly, I know that next year will be the general elections for the U.S. general election. So I would like to see more voters education forum for our Kababayans dito.
Okay.
I would really want them to be active and go out and vote in the forthcoming U.S. election. I don't care whom you vote for, but please have a stake in the outcome because the outcome will determine the future of mga Filipino community and the coming ones.
Agreed.
So I hope you can partner with us in coming up with the voters education. We started that actually last year, but with the COMELEC, the local COMELEC here in Chicago,
right.
We hope to do it more frequently next year before the November election. And second, I have been planning for a post-arrival orientation seminars. We did one in Chicago last year.
What is a post-arrival orientation?
This is really for newly arrived Filipino immigrants here.
Okay.
Or they might be students or those working. So they need information to navigate how to settle in. Of course, before those immigrants, Philippines, they receive pre-departure orientation seminar from the CFO, Commission of Filipinos Overseas.
Okay.
So what we would like to fill in is once they arrive here, what do they need to know?
Yeah.
How to apply for SS Social Security.
Okay.
What happens if you have a problem? They can also be briefed on immigration rules or Attorney General's office if they got into trouble. So that's what we did. That's a template we started in Chicago for newly arrived teachers last August.
Okay.
And next year, I have already made plans for one for Nebraska, the first one in the state of Nebraska. In fact, I'm partnering with Congressman Don Bacon in Nebraska, and I plan to have one in Michigan, Minnesota.
So you're expanding it out in the Midwest?
Yes.
In the 12 states you cover?
Oh, we'll see if we can do it.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's a one day orientation, and we need the cooperation of the federal agency. We have to invite the agency representative to brief the Filipinos.
You know, the best part of the Paskuhan is we have 30 organizations there, right?
Mm.
So a lot of us have different expertise in different subject matters.
Mm.
The best part of it all is this is something that we could, as a Paskuhan, make a model out of it.
Mm.
Actually, for those that are watching, if you could see our logo, Midwest Filipino American Coalition.
Mm-hmm.
That was actually sprouted and founded by Tito Ruben and me, John Paul Ferrer, because we were inspired with what you did with Paskuhan. And it's not so much to try to get membership, be in one organization. It's about a nonprofit reaching out to organizations to listen to what the Filipino American community needs here in the United States, whether it be support, like the post-orientation, the post-arrival
arrival,
orientation,
yes.
Or just celebrating the Christmas Pascuan every year. Our biggest biggest event is Piesta Pinoy, which I'll bring him in soon. But yeah, so anything else before?
Yeah, if you have one in Piesta Pinoy, maybe we can do one sometime in August on the other side of the... side of Chicago or Illinois, maybe.
Oh,
you
like
Western.
Like a Piesta Pinoy type
event? Street food festival or something like that.
Yeah, that would be the restaurant week, around the restaurant week.
Yes, along the, around the October, Philippine History Month.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I would like to congratulate everyone, you and Tito Ruben, for organizing that first ever parade, Columbus Day Parade. Which was really covered. I was really so excited. I was so thrilled to see our ladies, our beautiful women in their Santa Cruzan attire and with all this, you know, the wow, that's just really, I'm so proud
of
that.
So Kanja, notice here in Chicago that a lot of the youth and a lot of the younger kids are very much involved. Their parents are getting them involved in learning about our culture.
Yes.
And that's actually very, very interesting, and it's encouraging that we're not losing track of what that is, what that's about.
Oh, in relation to that, we are already embarked. We have already starting the second Midwest. That's another initiative I did. One Chicago, the Midwest Youth Leaders Immersion Program.
Right.
We did one successfully in January this year.
Yep.
In fact, Everett was one of those. We had more than 12 youth who participated.
Yes.
And the second one will be this coming next month,
January
3 to 9, 2020. And the Commission of Filipinos agreed to have another one, the third one in July,
for
summer. And I would like to thank your organization also for sponsoring some of the participants, too. And Tito Ruben, the PACF.
Right.
And of course, Ayala and other organizations.
So. So thank you, Kanjan. So what we're going to do now is call on...
And about the Midwest Philippine American, yes, I congratulate you for organizing this. I think that's what we need.
Yeah, it's not a membership thing. It's about a person or an organization trying to encourage all of these organizations. How can we help each other out?
Yes, I mean on a common
goal.
Theme,
yeah,
or on a theme that everyone shares.
Yes, Pascuan was your idea, and that's exactly what sprouted
well,
the impact we call ourselves.
Keep it up.
So yeah, thank you, Kan Jan. What we're gonna do is thank you for appearing today,
thank you.
I'm gonna go ahead and call Tito Ruben to give us an update of the new year and what's coming new.
Okay.
So Tito Ruben, while he's getting ready. Tito Ruben, welcome. I'm going to shake
again.
Your hand.
Yes.
In advance. You look so short. You want to adjust your seat to kind of get up a little bit here? So you said that you have some updates that you want to tell us about what's happening in 2020. So it's a new year already. Another decade has passed.
Yes. 2019 has been a very good year for us, not just for us, but for the whole Filipino community here in the greater Chicago area.
Okay.
And we're hoping that 2020 is going to be even bigger.
So you want me to show the first event that we're planning?
Yes. So the first event that we're doing is on January 18, 2020. And this is the third time that we're doing a gathering of Filipinos in the United Center for a Chicago Bulls game. Basketball has always been very popular sport in the Philippines. And so we're doing a Filipino night with the Chicago Bulls.
Perfect.
And that will be on Saturday, January 18, 2020.
Okay.
And it's the Bulls versus Chicago Cleveland, which included...
Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cleveland
Chicago
Cavaliers.
Bulls versus,
I'm sorry.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cleveland Cavaliers.
So
with Filipino-American Jordan Clarkson playing in the Cavaliers team.
Okay. Next.
In February, we have the Battle of the Bamboos. This is an annual gathering of student club organizations from the Midwest. hosted by University of Illinois in Chicago.
So it's what exactly is the Battle of the Bamboo? Is it a dancing competition?
Or? Yes, it is a dancing competition, and it's not just tinikling or bamboo dance. It's any cultural dance.
Right.
And this is choreographed by the students themselves.
So those are some of the outfits that they've worn in the past, is that right?
Yes, that's taken from last year's Battle of the Bamboo.
Perfect. And then next is the biggest event.
Of course.
So let's talk a little bit about that.
Okay, save the date. It's going to be on June 13, 2020. And this is now the seventh year of
yes.
Fiesta Pinoy. And as you know, it's getting bigger and bigger. So June 13, 2020, we invite everyone, organizations, performers, vendors, exhibitors, and everybody to participate in Fiesta Pinoy.
Got it. And obviously, there's a lot of news that are going to be announced about this year's Fiesta Pinoy.
That's correct. So watch out for announcements in Facebook and Instagram to find out who the performing artists will be at this year's Fiesta Pinoy.
And of course, a lot of these that we talked about, the IMPACT, Midwest Filipino American Coalition, we are calling for volunteers to help us execute Fiesta Pinoy.
That's correct. That's the only way we're able to continue Fiesta Pinoy with free admission. Everything is community-based, and we do need a lot of volunteers to help us with the event, because it's a 12-hour event.
Yes.
So.
And then, of course, you know, if you love to travel, there's this big, very VIP, very important Pinoy.
Yes, I included this. I thought the Consul General would actually advertise this, but this is a good way to see the Philippines with the Consul General and the other Consul Generals from other countries in the.
So it's all of the United States.
It's all of the United States.
They're all going to go on the same trip, already arranged. So people that are thinking about maybe visiting the Philippines or always visit the Philippines, it's a different type of experience altogether.
Yes, this year I think they're going to Boracay. So yeah. The first time that Boracay has now just opened.
Come on, Kanjan, let's talk about it because, you know, let it come from the important source. No? Okay. So so that's all the time we have, Tito Ruben. So
thank you.
We'll tape
thank
again
you.
And show them.
And Happy New Year to everyone.
Yes.
Oh, Merry Christmas first and then Happy New Year.
Yes, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. My name is John Paul Ferrer. Until next time.